a 4-time Jiu-Jitsu World Champion, several times European Champion, PANOGI Champion, World NoGi Champion, Brazilian National Champion, and so many other titles. Diogo Reis, very glad to have you here, brother.
What's up, guys? It's a pleasure to be here and do this podcast. My first time doing this, but I think I'm a little nervous, but let's make this flow everything.
Yeah, it's gonna be easy. It's just a conversation you hear with friends, and it's pretty the same we do every day. We talk, and we talk about life, we talk about jiu-jitsu, we talk about goals, we talk about accomplishments, so...
Everything.
You, Carlos.
You would think that with that amazing introduction, you would have had a super old guy in front of you with all those accolades, you know?
How old are you, Dioguinho?
19
years old. I had a black belt. Like, when I was 19, wow. I was purple belt. He's already black belt.
You remember when I saw you first time when I was open?
Yeah, right. That was the first time we saw?
Yeah.
We met?
Yeah.
I know you there. Nice.
Manaus open. You was a blue belt.
I was purple.
Purple?
Yeah. The only time I went to Manaus, I went to fight this Manaus open, was a purple belt.
Oh.
And I got the bogo.
I know. I was there.
And you fought this one? You fought this Manaus open?
Manaus open have kids, you know?
It was one of the only ones who have kids, right?
Yeah. I think only he open and Manaus open have.
Manaus open have a big culture. Why Manaus have that big culture of jiu-jitsu?
Bro, because I think in Manaus have a lot of projects, you know. Mm-hmm. Each street have one academy or small academy.
Right.
So it's free, you know. Everybody try jiu-jitsu. So it is to see people if you have talent.
They're like everywhere for free to train.
Yeah. Like now they start to make like a São Paulo, you know, more business, more class.
Right.
Separate the class, advanced, intermediary,
nice,
beginners.
Nice.
But there, most of them is like projects, you know?
And who brought the jiu-jitsu to Manaus? Because the jiu-jitsu started in Belém do Pará, right?
Yeah,
with the Gracies, and after came to Rio de Janeiro, and after it started got bigger. Who brought the jiu-jitsu to Manaus?
Good question. I don't know this.
But that's amazing when you're talking about the projects, right? How does it work? Can you explain it? I'm from Honduras, and I've always dreamt, I've talked to Cyborg about this, I've always dreamt of doing the first project over there, you know, for kids, you know, that are probably in the streets up to no good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, what has been the results in Brazil?
So, projects is to help kids to stay humble, stay educate the kids, because... Like in Brazil, you know, so much disrespectful, so much crime, yeah, crime?
Crime,
yeah, a lot of crimes, you know, especially nowadays. Uh-huh. So the goals of projects is to take kids, like a teenage, I know, green, junior,
teenagers,
yeah, on this age, to help them to stay with good people. You know, that's why you have a lot of projects in Brazil.
And it works, right?
And it works for real.
Yeah. I saw like a lot of talents you in jiu-jitsu nowadays come from projects, you know?
No, a lot. I come from a project too. Like, project is amazing. Like, if it was not the social project, I come from the social project of Cicero Costa.
Who
already built a lot of champions like Miel Brothers, Leandro Loa, Kainan Duarte, Gustavo Braguinha, Luisa Monteiro. You know? So when I used to watch like the Miel Brothers winning everything and just sleeping and eat, I think Miel Brothers made the jiu-jitsu like grow a lot, you know?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I think we need to give like a lot of responsibility.
You know, when I was in Manaus, I saw like a 2014,
right.
There was in Jiu-Jitsu Costa gym.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, for us, for me, for my friends who training a project, it's like a one inspiration, you know?
Exactly.
Bro, I want to go to Jiu-Jitsu Costa, sleep on the mat, stay with this guy, only train. It was a dream, bro.
And you did?
Yeah, you did. Like, for me, it was a great experience when I was... Like, my first Brazilian National was in 2014.
I think 2015, no?
No, this is why the second.
Oh, okay.
2014 was... No, sorry. 2015, yeah.
Yeah, I remember. I was there. Yeah,
I was there, man.
Then Mika, Mika was a orange belt and he went with a lizard on his head. Remember?
Yeah, I know.
Com largato na cabeça dele.
When I know Mika, he's more one age older than me.
1 year younger than you?
Yeah, yeah, one year younger than me. And, you know, I saw him make a lot of crazy styles on the head, crazy, you know? And I stay 1 week and a half in Cicero Costa on the mat, sleep, like for me, for my friends, it was a crazy experience because before we was talking about this and was living this.
Yeah, exactly.
We was able to see Leandro Lo, the pro trainer, you know, like only porrada.
In Brazil, we have a phrase, then we say, o pensamento é a força criadora. Like your thought is what make you do it's what create your reality, you know, and like, and I really believe on that because
me too.
A lot of the things that I really thought and I really believe it and it would be possible happened to me.